Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle and these three parts are given 4 units and there's an angle bisector line here and this length is given 6 root 2 and the question is what is the value of the x? First step, notice that these two lengths are equal and we have an angle bisector line here, that means triangle DBA is an isosceles triangle, right? So here must be equal 90 degrees, and these two parts must be equal. So let's write here, triangle DBA is an isosceles triangle. After that, if we extend point E like this, and let's call here A, and this part is called B, according to angle bisector theorem, 4 plus A must be equal 8 plus B. Right? Therefore, if you simplify the expression, that means B equal to A. Let's write here, B equal to A. Notice that 3A equal 6 root 2. That means A equal 2 root 2. Right? Let's write here. 2 root 2, and here is 4 root 2. Next step, if you draw a parallel line to line segment BE like this, if you notice that this triangle and this triangle are similar. Alright, so if it is M, that means here must be equal to M. Likewise, this triangle and this triangle are similar. Therefore, 4 over 8, this length, must be equal to m over x plus m, right? So if you simplify the expression, therefore x plus m equal 4m, that means x equal 3m. Let's write here, x equal 3m. After that, let's call these two equal sides y. Therefore, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get y squared plus m squared equal 2 root 2 whole squared. You know that 2 root 2 whole squared equal 8. And for this triangle, if you apply Pythagorean theorem, 3m whole squared plus y squared equal 4 squared. 3m whole squared equal 9m squared, and 4 squared equals 16. And if you multiply first equation by minus and add the equations together, notice that these are again, so 9m squared minus m squared equal 16 minus 8, right? Therefore 8m squared equal 8, so m squared equal 1, that means m is going to be 1 unit. Notice that x equals 3m, That means x equal 3. Okay, this was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x using second method. First of all, let's call these two equal angles alpha. After that, if you focus on the biggest triangle, for biggest triangle, we can apply cosine rule. Right? Okay. Therefore, 6 root 2 whole squared equal 4 squared plus 8 squared minus 2 times 4 times 8 times cosine 2 alpha. So, 72 equal 16 plus 64 minus 64 times cosine 2 alpha. Therefore, 64 cosine 2 alpha equal 8. So, cosine 2 alpha equal 1 over 8. Right? We know that the expansion of cosine 2 alpha equal 1 minus 2 times sine squared alpha equal 1 over 8. So 1 minus 1 over 8 equal 2 times sine squared alpha. Therefore, 7 over 16 equal sine squared alpha. Let's square root both sides of the equations. Therefore, sine alpha equal root 7 over 4. Then, if you focus on this triangle, you know that this triangle is an isosceles triangle. So here is 90 degrees and these two parts are equal. Let's call these two equal parts N. Therefore, for this triangle, sine alpha equal N over 4. Right? So n over 4 must be equal to root 7 over 4. Let's simplify the expression. That means n is going to be root 7. Let's write here n equal root 7. Final step for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, x squared plus root 7 whole squared equal 4 squared. Therefore, x squared equal 9, so x is going to be 3 units. Okay. Now we will calculate value of x using third method. You know that here is 90 degrees and these two parts are equal. Let's call these two equal parts k. Therefore, for this triangle, if we apply Stewart's theorem, according to Stewart's theorem, square of this length, 2k whole squared, must be equal square of this length times this part. So 4 squared times 4 plus square of this length times this part. So 6 root 2 whole squared times 4 over sum of these two parts, 4 times 4 minus the product of these two parts. So 4 times 4. Well, therefore 4k squared equal 16 times 4 plus 72 times 4 over 8 minus 16. Therefore, 4k squared equal, if you simplify the expression, 16 over 8 equal 2 and 72 over 8 equal 9. So 8 plus 36 minus 16. Therefore, 4k squared equal 28. Therefore, k squared equal 7. That means k is going to be root 7. Let's write here k equal root 7. So for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, x will be equal 3 units. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.